around me. Same squad, same squad, same squad. Drop top, coupe, Dodge, Range drops. Big back plays on FaceTime. Squad ain't with me, then it ain't right. Same squad, same squad, same squad. Drop top, coupe, Dodge, Range drops. Big back plays on FaceTime. Squad ain't with me, then it ain't right. Yeah, no it ain't, no it. They ain't talking cash, so I did the race. NASCAR with the pace, feed you water on the chain. You know love where I'm from. When I'm on a beat, I make it thump. I need that bread like every crumb. Came up from nothing, made a sum. I came up who I was down with. You change up, stay far from around me. I came up who I was down with. You change up, stay far from around me. Same squad, same squad, same squad. Drop top, coupe, Dodge, Range drops. Big back plays on FaceTime. Squad ain't with me, then it ain't right. Same squad, same squad, same squad. Drop top, coupe, Dodge, Range drops. Big back plays on FaceTime. Squad ain't with me, then it ain't right. Ay, 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 ay.
From the banks of the Ohio River, there's a look at Paul Brown Stadium here in Cincinnati, Ohio. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport. As both teams made their way out of the tunnel, these folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Tennessee Titans and the Cincinnati Bengals. Here we go. The final week of the NFL season, week 17, is underway. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Boise State alum, Jay Ajayi. And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and eight.
Defensively here, you're facing a top-five team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So when they're that high-powered, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20. Because to me, that's the magic number. 20 points scored gives yourself, you give yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
And I think so, because then you turn into a shootout, and that means your offense has to keep pace.
And they're able to get this one across the 35. It's a Bengal first down, a pickup of 11.
And there we see an early burst that makes him one of the leading rushers in the league.
Well, I want you to know, I listened to you yesterday when we were watching film. You said write down the word vision for him. It was on display there, wasn't it?
It certainly was, because he allows the blocks to set up in front of him. And if that continues, it could be a long afternoon for those guys trying to play some defense.
So after the run by Jay Ajayi, here's first and 10. A first carry for the Clemson man, Wayne Gallman. And a good swarm to the football defensively as they get him down at about the 40. Jonathan Hankins in on the stop.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
No. Check. Patriot!
On the ground, this is Jalen Richard. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. The tackle there by Quandre Diggs. Defense doing their job, really nowhere to run the football.
Yeah, it was almost textbook, wasn't it? Every place he tried to find an open spot, there just wasn't one. Congrats to the defense, no gain.
Call fitting your gaps, right?
I love it. You're exactly right.
A throw there, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
And third down is a key down in any game you play. And third down defense, something we've got to watch in this one. Got to be effective on the passing downs. That's a pretty good first step right there.
And they'll indeed go for it with Rosen. Escaping the pressure right. And this is caught. That's Watkins. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. That one good for 17 yards on fourth. Couldn't ask for much more from your offense there. First down. So operating from Tennessee territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 43. They run with Ajayi. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size and these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense because you're excited about hitting him in the first half. Maybe not so much in the second half as some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
Fighting his way down to about the 35-yard line. Just a couple on the pickup there, and now it's third down.
Watching that play unfold and watching him complete it brought back memories of doing all those pursuit drills to make sure you don't over-pursue and let a guy get a cutback lane on you. He did that very well.
You praised him on tape yesterday for the angles that he takes to the ball. Took a great angle right there. Now it's Ajayi. Fights loose. Ajayi hit. He lost the football. And he's able to get it to the 31, and that's enough for the first. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Running game working, they'll stick with it on first down. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. That one good for 15, and the Bengals get a first down. Quite the opening drive march they're on right now.
It looks a lot like what we saw in practice prior to the game, doesn't it? You know, because on that last big practice beforehand, you go through your offensive script, you go through your play calling, you go through all the stuff and establish things, and it looks like it's going like clockwork right now for them.
Here's Gallman, and he'll take this one down near the 15. Credit him with a 1-yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9.
I think that's the type of run we'll continue to see throughout this game. The snow coming down, I don't expect a lot of big plays to be broken. There we go.
Ooh, that's what I'm talking about, baby. Gone, 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 gone.
Four down. Here's Ajayi, and he stopped immediately there. Officially, no gain on the play, and they're left with a 3rd and 8. Off the corner, where'd he come from? Well, I guess he came off the corner, but really nice play.
I like when you're able to pose a question and answer it at the same time. That's exactly where he came from, but it's not something that you normally see. Most of the time, we're thinking about those guys covering pass catchers. In this case, he was a big factor in a run game, no gain.
And now it's Rosen looking. And that is incomplete.
And that's a crusher right there. Had his man open for a first down. Threw a fastball when that wasn't necessary. Incomplete pass. When are these quarterbacks going to learn? You don't get extra points by how hard you throw the football.
And the kick by Butker is good. And the Bengals are on the board first here. It's 3-0. So they get the field goal, but that was a 14-play drive to get 3.
You sound like you're going negative on me.
I was.
Sounds like you're thinking the 3 is just not that good.
And people say that we're negative sometimes. So.
Well, here's the deal. Getting the 3 is good. Obviously, you would think on a 14-play drive you're going to get 6 out of it. But that type of a drive can pay dividends later on because you might wear the defense down.
And now movement here right away. Maybe a sign of things to come with this crowd. A false start backs him up 5. 1st and 15.
Tiger, Tiger, Tiger.
Watson now to throw. This is Bell on the dump ball. Nothing on that one. It'll be 2nd down.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained, so they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly.
Play
fake, and it's Watson. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. It'll be a pickup of 15 as that'll lead to third down.
If you're running out route, it's likely you end up near the sideline. And what did we just see there?
Toe tap.
You got it. The benefits of practice. Toe tapping, foot dragging, picking it up, and making sure it was a catch.
Now the first carry for Ty Montgomery. And he'll be taken down as that will take us to the end of the first quarter. Here on first down, he completes it to Julio Jones. 20, and he does take it in for the touchdown, but a flag on the field, and I don't think this is going to stand.
Yeah, don't put the points on the board just yet.
Come back.
Now a play fake here on first down. And that'll be incomplete.
Had an open man that time, but ended up putting a little too much heat on it, don't you think, partner?
Absolutely. Just needed a touch more air under it. Instead, he fired an absolute bullet. So second down and 10. Once again, they'll go from the 40.
Back 22.
Watson, off play action. Wide open receiver complete. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop him. A good pickup there, 26 yards.
Quarterbacks love slant routes because the receivers are breaking right into their line of vision.
Receivers
love them as well because they're getting the ball on the move and able to catch it and try and get upfield and gain additional yardage.
And incomplete, he dropped it in the end zone.
Once you get into the red zone and the safeties have less ground to cover, you'd better be quick with your delivery. Not much space to get a ball in there.
Yeah, when that field shrinks with those safeties, it's almost like there's a couple extra defenders out there, right?
It certainly is. They end up taking up extra space just because there's not enough space for receivers to run through.
Back to the air, Watson on second down. And into the end zone for a Tennessee touchdown. Julio Jones, his ninth touchdown of the season. And the Titans are able to strike for six. You always worry about the plant foot in the snow, but no problems there. And that makes it a 7-3 lead. Gold now out to kick it away. The Bengal offense now gets set to head back out onto the field. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. And at least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them want it to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you met fan bases that wanted that, that weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants to drive down with a kick, other than the extra point. That's it.
He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
Even without a ton of pressure in his face, it just shows how difficult it is to pick apart his own defense. Those guys are sitting back, and they're not playing receivers as much as they're playing the eyes of the quarterback and when he delivers the ball.
Throw left side, taken in by Hill. A good pick up there, 26 yards.
Some think the teams really won't throw a slant route unless you have a receiver that has a lot of stature to him. But sometimes the little guys, they get lost in there. People can't really locate them. And they run that quick cut on the slant, and oftentimes they can turn into big plays.
That's caught inside the 20. And they're going to have this all the way down deep into Tennessee territory. And give them a gain of 37.
In our pregame meeting, all they talked about was keeping him hemmed in and wanting him to make his throws from the pocket because they knew he was pretty dangerous if he got outside, and he just showed it right there. Pretty good arm, too.
And he's got it. Touchdown, Bengals. As his guys are in for six, and the Bengals are in for six.
Granted, my man, just one sentence for that one. Clinic.
And that's what they've done. They lead the league in points per game this season, but it's been quick strike ability, as we saw on that drive.
I think they're actually intimidating defenses because they're back on their heels right away, wondering where it's going to come from, how they're going to hit them. This group is well-organized, well-coached, and extremely confident in what they do.
Butker now to kick this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback.
The Titans offense now, they work their way back onto the field. Even though they might not find the number one seed next to their name come playoff time, there's not going to be very many teams, if any, entering the playoffs on the kind of run they're on. They're hot.
And I love that word, hot, because every team in the league wants to go into the playoffs on that uptick because a lot of the time you serve notice to the rest of the league that, hey, we're the team you need to deal with. We're the team that's going to be a real problem for you. And if they can continue this streak, they could very well be that team and gain that confidence that they're seeking as they head to the playoffs.
And confidence, that's the word I would use from our meetings with them. They said we're playing our best football right now. It is showing. Here's second and seven now from the 28. Faking the give. Now Watson. The left side caught by Diggs. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 13 yards is the pickup for Tennessee and a first down. Off of play action, it's Watson. Looking for Diggs, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Landon Collins. And they get the football. They'll set up shop at their own 49-yard line.
Well, I get what he was trying to do. He was moving to his right and trying to shift the coverage. But instead, he shifted the coverage also to the right and threw right into it for an interception.
They've got good starting field position as they come up here first and 10. On the ground, Richard. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. Nice way to start the drive, a gain of 12 and a first down.
The timing and the faking on that play was so good, you almost think you're at a magical act, right? The magician has shown you something, and then you realize it's not really there. He's created an illusion, and the illusion was they were going to throw the football. Looked like a pass play. Instead, it turned into a draw. Offensive lineman able to get out in front. They drew the defensive line upfield and beat them at their own game, and that's why they picked up big yardage into the secondary.
Gun!
On second down, here's Rosen. Throw right side is into the hands of his tight end, Everett. And this time not quite to the 30. It'll be down at the 31-yard line. That catch good for five. It's third down. Now Rosen looking at a third and two. He is going to find Hill here. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. That'll put him at an even 50 receiving yards now in this first half. And it's a first down. 2 minutes to play here in the first half. We'll come back to Cincinnati after this. Throwing now, Rosen on first down. And that is caught. He's got it for a Bengal touchdown. In for the score. And the Bengals are able to grow their lead. And he's a little bit on the shorter side as a receiver. Maybe sometimes for the defense, tough to find the little guys, right?
Yeah, sometimes they get lost in the traffic. But usually what it means is that rather than just winning with height or even speed, they use their quickness to find a way to get open.
Well, tall, short, wide, skinny, whatever. There it results in a touchdown. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Out come the Titans now. A tale of two extremes already in this game. A touchdown pass on their opening drive followed by an interception last time out.
Now, it sounds like things balance out, right? What's that mythological thing that we do? If you have a candy bar, have a diet soda with it, it balances it out. And we know that's not really true, right? Because the interception, that sting lingers a little bit longer. Got to come out now and put together some nice plays.
Trying to shake off the interception, he'll look to throw. But it looked like the Titans were able to recover, and indeed, they will keep possession of the ball.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back. Because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
On second down, here's Watson. He's got the connection over the middle to Diggs. And way up past the 35 before he's taken down. A good pickup there of 22. On first down, Watson goes underneath for Bell. And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage. It'll be back at the 36. It'll be a loss of one, and it'll be second and 11. Again, it's Watson. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. As it comes with 22 seconds to go here in half number one. So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. First down throw, Watson throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And they'll get this one to about the 20-yard line. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead, as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the first half. Watson now rebounding nicely after the interception. He's hit four straight to start the drive. It's first down. From the red zone now, Watson. Got a man, and it's taken in for a Titans touchdown. Christian Kirk, as the first half is winding down. And the Titans are able to make this a close game again. Point after try forthcoming. Point after, right down the middle. And the lead's down to a field goal at 17-14. Gold now out to kick it away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have stayed where he was, as he'll only get back to the 16-yard line. The Bengals getting set to go. And you got to think, if this is anything other than just taking a knee, I'd be very surprised.
Yeah, they've got enough to talk about at the half. Why do anything else? Just get out of there.
Likely time for one final snap as they start out first and 10. They'll begin the drive with a Johnny. And that closed up quickly there as he gets it up only to about the 17. And we're going to get a timeout with 2 seconds remaining in the second quarter.
Right? They just gave up a big yardage play, right?
And now it's going to stand. The
only thing I can think, someone is mad at their own defense, and they're trying to teach them a really, really crazy lesson.
The final two quarters of the NFL regular season are upon us as the second half of Week 17 is underway. And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. The Titan offense now working their way back onto the field. They're close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess it in the locker room. They talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there. Just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up. Flush to his right. Caught here by Bell. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. That goes for a gain of 31.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play. They picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
They'll fake the handoff. Now Watson. And Jones has it over the middle. The Titans efficient passing on this drive. There's another first down.
Not only have they completed a couple on this drive, but they peeled off some pretty good chunks of yardage, too.
Absolutely. Great start. Two nice plays in the pass game. Now can they continue to feed off that? Now a first down carry by Bell. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down.
Would you say this offense is locked in right now?
They're having no trouble on this drive. What is it, three plays, three first downs?
Yeah, you talk about on the march. They keep this up, they'll get to that end zone real fast.
On the ground, this is Ware. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. And what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play.
Come back.
On that one, he looked like one of those guys.
To throw on second is Watson. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1 yard line. A good decision in the end to pull it and run, get some 9 yards and a first.
That's something we have not seen him do to this point, and that's take the ball, tuck it, and run.
Exactly right. His first carry of the game. And he will take this one in for a Titans touchdown. Ty Montgomery, his first touchdown on the year. And the Titans are able to strike for 6. Solid job up front. Really just a solid job all the way around to get that one in.
Yeah, that was well executed, wasn't it? Well blocked, well run. End result, 6 points.
Touchdown. Gold now out to kick it away. That'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. So here are the Bengals now as they get their first possession of this second half. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. 10 yards there to start the drive, and just enough by about the length of the football for a first down. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. They'll look to throw on first down with Josh Rosen. Going deep here for Watt. He's got a man complete. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. A gain of 32 that time.
Now that play will end up on the highlights, and you'll see it all over the place. But what you won't see, the offensive line that bought the extra time, that allowed for the big completion downfield, those guys made that play possible.
This is a giant. And he'll get this down to about the 30, 31-yard line. The tackle there by Quandre Diggs.
What's the old expression, 3 yards in a cloud of dust? In this case, it's dust-covered pellets. It's no longer that old grass that we used to play on, right, and chew it up. Now we've got that artificial surface. You see the pellets go up. Still a nice play by the defense.
And going deep for Hill. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
That's very well timed there defensively, because it's not a bad throw, but the collision came at the exact time he was reaching to bring in the football. Really, really well done.
Decent offense, just better defense. I think you're right. Losing 9 yards there. And it also brings up fourth. And how about this? Fourth and long, and they're going to go for it. They're going on fourth down. Rosen, he's going to wind up and air it out. And my goodness, this is incomplete. The Bengals try it, but it doesn't work out. And as a result, it'll be Titan football on the turnover on downs. Here's the Titan offense now as they make their way back onto the field. And the points, they have come fast and furious in this quarter.
You really don't want to be on the defensive side of the ball right now, do you? Because you're either thinking my replacement may get an opportunity.
Your head better be on a swivel.
Totally. Or maybe I just need to get out of the game for a while, because I just can't slow these guys down. They've got to figure out a way to disrupt these offenses. And typically, one guy makes a big play, and that can help change things.
They'll be looking for disruption on both sides right now. Rare. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. Give him 3 yards and a fresh set of downs.
Second and one, and people want to run the football. This is where every back in the league is supposed to do exactly what we just saw there. Pick up the first down.
Play fake. Watson. That was going to throw deep right side. So they took a shot on first down, but couldn't connect.
Well, that certainly looked like something that they discussed all week in practice, getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, you'll open up the defense a little bit, loosen them up, have them back on their heels. Come back.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Throwing again is Watson. He's got it complete to Diggs, right side. And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. That'll put him at 95 receiving yards now as he's got a first down. Back now in Cincinnati. It's the Titans. They've got the football. They'll be looking to extend their lead here as we begin the fourth quarter.
Watson now, five straight completions here in this second half, first and 10. A give to Bell. And past the 30, down to about the 27. A solid run on first down, gain of 7, leaves him with a second and 3. And I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely, you want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
Again, it's Bell. Down right around the 25. The safety, Landon Collins, there to make the tackle. The good run on first down followed up by a not-so-good run on second down.
Now let's find out if they're going to stick with the run here on third down. A lot of people would love to see some play action here. I say go with your best running play over your best blocker.
Now a play fake, and it's Watson sliding out of the pocket. That's incomplete, but there is a flag down. So hang on, a big call coming on third down. So they were looking to throw, holding on the big right tackle.
That's real simple, partner. Keep your hands inside in the chest area. You're probably okay. You get it out on the shoulders, get them wide. You're just going to pick up a holding call.
And this third down looking very tough after the holding penalty. Third and long. Watson off the play fake. And he's able to find Diggs. And he'll get this one down to about the 20-yard line. He has a first down, and that catch will also put him over 100 yards receiving now on the afternoon. The give is to Bell, and he'll get this one down to about the 17. The tackle will be credited to Jake Ryan.
And that's one of the reasons you like to blitz even on rundowns. It confuses the blocking assignments. It doesn't allow those offensive linemen to get up to the second level.
This drive's taken more than 3 minutes off the clock already as they come up on second down. They'll go again with Bell, and he'll be stopped after a gain of only a couple down to the 15-yard line.
Brandon, we talk all the time about those hybrid players, guys who can do more than one thing, and I think if you're playing strong safety in the NFL today, you are a true hybrid, part linebacker, part cover guy.
And coming up, sticking his nose in the mess there and making a nice play defensively. From the gun on third, Watson. This will be caught just inside the 10. And able to get him down, but he does reach the 5. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. So first and goal, 6 points here would go a long way toward wrapping this one up. Now Bell. Going to get him about 3 yards closer. He's down to about the 2.
This is where coaches have to have spent a lot of time going over situations with their players, because him getting tackled there is not the worst thing in the world. You're going to run more plays, right? Clock's going to go. But his thought process is getting into the end zone. It's counterintuitive for him to actually go down in this spot.
Yeah, but and he gets in. Touchdown, Tennessee. Ty Montgomery with 2 touchdowns on the season, both in this game. And the Titans find a way to stretch their lead. Extra point was hooking, but he does make it through. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. Gold now out to kick it away. Charles, this one, not over, certainly, but you set the magic number earlier in this game at 20 points, said that they would need to hold them right around that marker under it. What are you seeing here?
Well, that number is still in play because we said, okay, 20 or under gives them a chance to win, right on pace for being in that range, and guess what? They've got a shot.
Fire, fire. Rosen on first and 10. He's going to look deep for Watkins. This is taken in. It's complete. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. That one goes for 36 yards. Now Rosen on first down. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
And that's one he's got to be happy to have back. There wasn't a hole open in the zone.
You'd have to think on early downs like that first down there, need to be a little bit more careful.
Yeah, fortunately for him, got a couple more downs to play with.
To throw is Rosen. Throw left side, taken in by Hill. A good pickup there, a 22. That's the number two receiver in the NFL in terms of yardage. And tell you what, a few more plays like that, he won't be number two for long.
Well, that's what often happens when you have competitors running around the field. These guys know where they stand in relationship to yardage, totals, numbers, the whole deal. And let's face it, all of them, they all want to be number one.
17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling. Time for a break. We'll come back to wrap this one up after this. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit. And he takes it into the end zone. Touchdown, Bengals. Josh Rosen taking it in. And the Bengals able to get this back within a touchdown. And they wasted no time right down near the goal line. And they just sneak it in.
Just do what you need to do. Big guys going up front. Have the field general, the leader, just fall in behind them.
They're going to try and run. And he will get into the end zone as a two-point conversion is successful. And the lead is down to a field goal here in the fourth. Butker now to kick this one away. We saw a number of good games earlier today. This one might top all of those. It's been a dandy as we come up on first and 10. They'll start out on the ground with Bell. Room here to run. Le'Veon Bell. Kiss him goodbye. A big play on the ground there. It goes for 36 yards.
But they picked up a little bit of yardage there, and now, in this situation, should be in no hurry to run a play really fast. Let the clock wind down.
And they'll keep it on the ground with Bell. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. And now the Bengal defense here calling a timeout as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Second down, it's Bell. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. And now the Bengals are going to call another timeout as they get the stoppage with 65 seconds remaining. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Bell. And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. And now we're going to get a timeout here called by the defense as they get the stoppage with just over a minute to go in the game. You'd have to think likely another running play coming here, second and 11. The Titans go victory formation down to a knee. They will take the knee here, and they will finish this regular season with a victory.
Yeah, it's fun to kneel down in front of your home crowd, but when you go on the road, that band of brothers attitude, right, just us against the world, and get it done, how happy are they?
I remember a coach at a previous stop telling me, you get a win on the road, doesn't matter the opponent, get out of there like you stole something, and they did in this one.
Well, partner, there's something special about a game in the snow.